morning, everybody. It's day 30 of the 100-Day Project. Welcome back. Before I get started on the project, I just want to take the time to say thank you so much to all of my subscribers, old and new. I don't feel as though I've expressed my gratitude and appreciation enough with this project going on. I have gained a lot of new subscribers, and I'm so grateful for that, but with everything going on, I just don't feel like I've taken the time to really say thank you, and I want to do that right now, because this has been a very wonderfully strange journey that I've been on. I've always loved to create, but the junk journal journey has been fairly recent, in that I think it's only been about 2.5, maybe 3 years I've kind of been dabbling in this side of creating journals. So I never set out with the intention of creating a YouTube channel whatsoever. It held no interest for me, but as things have went along, I've just felt like, you know, I needed to push myself outside of my comfort zone, because this is totally not something that I am comfortable with at all. I don't know how I come across to anybody, but I can tell you it's not something that I really am at ease doing. But regardless, this is where I am. This is where the journey's brought me. And I've said time and time again in my videos that I know that we don't grow as a person unless we're in very uneasy situations. So thank you guys so much for your support. I really do appreciate it. But on that note, I have made the decision that today will be the last day of the 100-Day Challenge or project for me. I hope you guys will understand it. It's a decision I've made for many reasons, a lot of them personal, which I will not share, but the side that I do feel comfortable sharing with you is that it's put enormous pressure on me. And, you know, I don't know where each of you are in your life. Everybody's dealing with very different, you know, problems and issues. Or maybe you are there and you're extremely blessed, and things are smooth sailing, in which case you probably think, well, that's just a ridiculous, how can it be that stressful to come on here for 15, 30 minutes a day and craft? And if that, you know, is your opinion, then you're certainly entitled to it. But for me, it's just too much. And like I said, a lot of it, I don't feel as though this is the place, you know. It's very personal things, and I'm a very private person. But it is limiting my creativity because of the pressure to create something each day. And I'm not enjoying it. It's too much pressure. So I hope you guys will understand. I am glad I participated. I feel that I have pushed myself, and for that I'm very grateful, but I think right now is the time for me to step aside from it. I have great respect for the ladies who are able to get on and do a video every day. I know some of them are even multiple times in the day. I don't know how they do it, but I have huge respect for them. I can't do that. And for me, I want to be here because I'm excited to share something that I've learned with you, not out of obligation. And that's where the decision has come from. So thank you guys. I hope that you'll understand. I know there'll be a percentage of you that won't and will decide to move on. And that's totally fine. I get it. I've said time and time again, I'm not here for any other reason than I love crafting, and that's why I'm here. So anyways, having said that, let's move on. This is going to be my last project, but I do want to say this. I am going to carry on with a Create With Me, and my intention is to do at least one video a week, and you know, some weeks I may be able to do two or three. But what I don't need is the pressure of feeling as though, oh, tomorrow I've got to have a project. I find that too restrictive for me. So anyways, today's project, it's very simple. This is not the project, by the way. This is for an upcoming journal I'm working on for my design team for Dreams, etc. And this kit, if anybody's been sitting here thinking, oh, I love those images, that's from the Cottage Rose kit from Dreams, etc. And you will see a journal probably in the next week and a half for that design team project. I'll share with you today, this is the journal, but I'm not going to show you guys all of it because I'll reveal it when the project's done. This is the project I'm going to create today, and it's really simple, but I just think it's a very effective addition to a journal. And I just, I've sewn this one in. The ones I'm going to make today are going to be split and stitched so that they can just be floating throughout a journal, but I really wanted to stitch this in. And if you do decide to use the project today and sew it in as I've done, I highly recommend you cut the flap before you sewed it in, because I got in a hurry and did not do that step. So so it's a little bit wonky there, but anyways, we won't dwell on the negative. So what you're going to need is, you guys know, I'm always trying to find a use for these large doilies, because when we buy doilies, most of the time we're picking them up from, you know, the Dollar Tree or just any place where we can get them at a reasonable price. And then you end up with these big ones. And so I've been trying to work them into projects so that I can use them rather than just cutting them up, because I find them really fiddly when I cut them up. So I'm using baking paper just because in the UK the baking paper is very inexpensive. Wax paper is very difficult to get your hands on here. I have wax paper. I purchased it from Whole Foods here a couple years back. So I do have it, but it's not cheap. And you're going to use a lot of it, so I opt to use that. So just whatever works for you guys. It does need to be a white. You could use a craft color, but I don't think it would look as nice. And then what I've done is just sandwiched the doily, and I run the doily all the way up to the edge of the paper, because I'm going to run this through the machine just to get it held in place, and then I'll come back to you and we'll trim it off, and that way you can see. It's very straightforward, guys. I mean, you probably don't even need a tutorial, but I just thought I'd share this. So I'll run it to the machine and I will be back, and we'll get this all cut down and do the next step. Okay, everybody, I'm back. I hope you can see. I've stitched along that the edge of the doily, And now I just want to trim this down before I run it back through the machine. And just cut any excess paper away, trying to get it as close as you can to the doily without cutting the doily, because it's really pretty to see the edges on that. And it adds a nice, for those of you who really like the sound in your journal, it adds a nice little crunch to the journal as well. So just kind of try to round those a little bit. You can leave the strings if you want to. I'm not going to on this one. Okay, so with putting it within the signature, I just folded it up. Actually, I'll drop that down slightly and have it. That was how I did it. And then I just ran the machine here and here, folded this down, and then you would want to measure out where you're going to sew that in, and on each side of where you feel like the center is going to be, I'd snip that so that it will open. You can do it afterwards, because I did, but it just, you know, it wasn't as easy to do as if you opted to do it now. But I now want to, I've decided I want to make these into floating pockets, so I'm just going to eyeball what I think is the center. I really don't like doing stuff with scissors. I'd rather run it through the cutter, but I don't want to do that on this one because that blade is getting dull and it'll just shred it, I'm certain. So I'm just going to run this up the center. And now I'm going to take it back to the machine, run a stitch along here, and then I'm going to fold it up and stitch this, and then we'll be back to just finish this off. So I will be back. Okay, guys, I am back, and I hope you can see this. I wonder if it would be better. Let me try to put this on a darker pattern. Let's see if that will show up a little bit better there. So there we are. I've stitched it, so we've got the little pocket now. And, you know, if you wanted, you could run a few more stitches across here to make it look a little bit, you know, on the top. You could do a little bit so it looks a little more quilted. But obviously, before you sew this together, if you're going to do that on the whole thing. But I like it. I think they're... you know, just something different to add. Now, the only other thing I want to do, and I'll probably just get one of these done, is I just stitched a little bit of fabric. I just took a tiny bit of fabric and a little bit of trim there, and then I'm going to put the button and just sew that on. Like it's a button closure. It's not going to be, but it just will give the effect that it is. So, and then we can, afterwards we can ink it up if we want to age it slightly. Sorry, this is going to be difficult for me to sew on camera, I think. There we go. Yeah, I wanted to have a really great project when I made the decision, you know, that this would be the last day. But I just couldn't come up with anything. And I thought, well, a lot of people probably wouldn't have seen these. Oh, boy, I don't know why that's not going through. I must have knotted it on live TV. Yeah, I must have knotted that up. Doggone it. Well, there we go. It's not going as planned again. But as I said, I really do appreciate everybody has been, well, not everybody, but most of you have been amazing. There's been a few, you know, haters, but that's okay. I knew it was going to be that way when I decided to have a channel, and you know, I'm human. There are days that maybe it doesn't roll off quite as easily as it should. But like I said, I'm a human being, and we've all got feelings, and some people in the world are just not nice, and I don't know why, but that's just the way the world is, and it's sad, but I don't want to focus on that. I want to focus on the nice people, the kind people that I've come in contact with. And the rest of them, you know, you just kind of pray for them, because it says a lot about somebody who has to make other people's lives miserable. Life is hard enough without people out there trying to be malicious and bring somebody down, because this life is not easy. Not easy at all. But like I said, I'm not going to focus on that. I'm just going to focus on the good things and just, you know, say a prayer that those people will find some happiness. That must be a very miserable existence when you have to seek out people . So these were just some little scraps that I had. You guys know I love fabric, and oh my gosh, I'm having all sorts of issues today. I don't know what's going on. Crazy. I've been trying to get, you know, a bigger assortment, and I ordered some little scrappy packs online. This is where I've gotten these. I love this one because it's got the teal. That's such a pretty color. I'm not making any progress in my journal for my own little ideas. I'm hoping if I get some time, I've got several projects I've got to get completed, and then I want to start trying to make some embellishments in bulk. I know I keep saying that. I've been saying that for 2 years. but I must get started, because this is not efficient the way I'm doing it. I do each project. You know, I do the embellishments for each project during the project, and I know most people don't operate that way, and which is probably why they can produce journals as quick as they are, but I can't do it, and I'm really working to try to. Oh, I like how those have come out. They're sweet, aren't they? Really delicate, and like I said, they got a nice sound for those of you who like that. And again, if you want to sew it into the journal, that's how it's going to look, so that you can just flip it over. I hope you like it. Yeah, I'm sure somebody else has done it. I just haven't seen anybody. But I'm sure it's a very creative group of folks on here. So I'm sure at some point somebody must have done this before. So anyways, guys, that's the end of that project for today. I want to get this up, and I hope you guys are having a great week. I hope it continues to be a great week. And I will be back with something very soon, I'm sure. So thanks again, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.